Hi and welcome to ISBI. Today I'm gonna make two easy to build and very accurate doweling jigs. As by the last few projects, I use plywood scraps to build this jig. For these two jigs, I cut four pieces of plywood to size, two for the one jig and two for the other. For one jig, I glue two pieces together. After I get rid of the glue rest, I mark and drill two holes. I mark it asymmetrical because I want to use this jig to butt joint and to joint miters as well. In this way, there is no need to measure when I joint miters. To drill the holes in the other pieces, I clamp them together. Double-sided tape would do the job as well. For this second jig, you don't have to drill the holes with the drill press. You can drill the holes by hand because it doesn't matter if the holes are slightly angled. For the guide plates, I use, different than other makers, plywood. In my opinion, there is no need to make these guide plates from acrylic glass. To guide the drill and preventing the plywood from wearing out, I use steel tubes that I cut to size. But first I have to drill out this tube because on the inside is a little weld. Then I make a little chamfer on the inside diameter so the drill can easily slide in. To press these tubes in the plywood pieces, I use my vise. For the second jig, it's important that the tubes are pressed in from the right side. That means, when the pieces are drilled in this position, the pieces have to be flipped 90 degrees, and the guide plate will be in like this, and the tubes have to be pressed in from the other side. In case that I want to position this jig by using a mark which will be right in the middle between the two holes, I drill two holes in the guide plate. Then I make a little center mark on the drill piece. Here you can see that two windows are enough to see the mark on the jig and also on the workpiece. Then I glue on the guide plate. I glue it on with the overhang on both sides, so I can drill one workpiece from one side and the second workpiece from the other side. In this way, I can be sure that the holes are exactly in the right place, and it has not to be as accurate as the one-sided jigs that everyone makes. So the first jig is finished. As I mentioned earlier, it's important in which position these pieces will be glued to the guide plate. So the second jig is finished. So let's see how accurate these jigs work. I don't use marks to position these jigs. I just set the edge from the workpiece against the edge from the jig. To drill the second workpiece, I use the other side of the jig. It works nearly perfect. There is a tiny little overhang, but I could live with that. So let's see how the second jig works. With the second jig, you have to clamp both workpieces to the jig as demonstrated. This second jig works just perfect, not the tiniest overhang, just awesome. Of course, you can use these jigs to butt joint workpieces as well. You have just to set the edge of the jig against a marking line, clamp it, and drill the holes. Which one of these jigs you will use is up to you. With the first jig, the clamping is a lot easier. If you haven't a drill press, I would build the second one. Accurate are both of them. The second just a tiny bit more accurate. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click the notification bell and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!